Hello everyone. Now I am going to present about the introduction of an operational amplifier. In short form, we can call it as op-amp. Until now, we have discussed about the introduction of an IC, that is definition of an IC, classification of an IC, or advantages of an IC, that may be either linear or digital. From now onwards, we are focusing on linear integrated circuits or linear ICs. In part of that, operational amplifier is one of the linear ICs. This is the best example for the linear IC. So what is an op-amp or operational amplifier? An operational amplifier denotes a special type of amplifier that by proper selection of components could be configured for variety of applications. So this is a special type of amplifier. By proper selection or connection of components to the op-amp, it can be used for various applications. Originally, op-amp was an electronic circuit that can carry out many mathematical operations like addition, subtraction, differentiation, and integration. Hence the word operational. And it is used to amplify the both AC and DC signals. That means here we can apply both AC signals as well as DC signals. So coming to the history of an op-amp, first patent for vacuum tube op-amp was obtained in 1946. This figure represents the op-amp with vacuum tubes. And next, first commercial successful monolithic op-amp was obtained in 1965. This figure represents the monolithic op-amp. And next, this slide represents the symbol of an op-amp. So op-amp is a triangular in circuit schematic. This figure represents the op-amp, which is in triangular shape. And mainly, the op-amp consists of five terminals. Two terminals are input terminals. Two terminals are power supply terminals. One terminal is the output terminal. So here 2 and 3 represents the input terminals. One is inverting input terminal, another one is non-inverting input terminal. Inverting input is nothing but here we are applying the input to the inverting terminal of the op-amp. Non-inverting input means here we are applying the input to the non-inverting terminal of the op-amp. And 7th pin is used to apply the positive power supply. 4th pin is used to give the negative power supply. And 6th pin is used to take some output. And the next pin diagram of an op-amp or IC741. 741 is also called as op-amp. So here this figure represents 8-pin op-amp or 8-pin IC. So first pin represents offset null pin. Second pin is inverting input terminal. And third pin is non-inverting input. Fourth pin is negative power supply. Fifth pin is offset null pin. 6th pin is the output pin, 7th pin is positive power supply, and 8th pin is no connection, that is NC. So 1st and 5th pins are same, and these pins are called offset null pins, and these pins are used to nullify the output whenever there is no input. So next, 2nd and 3rd pins are the input terminals. 2nd pin is used to give the input, and as well as 3rd pin is also used to give the input. 4th pin is used to give some negative power supply. 7th pin is used to give some positive power supply. And 6th pin is used to take some output. 8th pin is NC pin, that is no connection pin. To this pin, we are not applying any input. And this figure represents the clear pin diagram of IC741. Next, output voltage. The op-amp produces an output voltage, that is the difference between the two input terminals multiplied by the gain. So here we are applying two inputs. One is to the non-inverting input terminal, another one is to the inverting input terminal, and the output is represented as Vout. So Vout is equal to K into V plus minus V minus. So where V plus is non-inverting input, V minus is inverting input, V out is output, Vs plus is positive power supply, Vs minus is negative power supply. And this is the mathematical expression for the output of an op-amp. And we have some golden rules for the op-amp. We have two rules for the op-amp. First rule is input currents for the op amp is zero in ideal case. That means the input for both the input terminals is zero. And next, the second rule is difference in input voltages is zero. The difference voltage between these two terminals is zero in ideal case. So we should follow these two rules for the op amp in ideal case. Next, ideal op amp characteristics. So mainly we have the characteristics of an op amp in ideal case as infinite open loop voltage gain, infinite input impedance, zero output impedance, zero noise contribution, zero DC output offset voltage, infinite bandwidth, and differential inputs that stick together. So first one is infinite open loop gain. So open loop gain is the gain of the op amp without any positive or negative feedback. So in that case, the gain is known as open loop gain. The gain of the open loop gain for the ideal op amp is infinite. Second one is infinite input impedance. As we know, the input impedance is the ratio of input voltage to the input current. Mathematically, that is represented as Z is equal to V by I. V is input voltage, I is input current. And we already know the input current for the op amp in ideal case is zero. So that is, if I is equal to zero, obviously the impedance Z is infinite. Third, zero output impedance. The ideal op amp acts as a perfect internal voltage source with no internal resistance. So that's why the output impedance in ideal case is zero. And next, zero noise contribution. In the ideal op amp, zero noise voltage is produced internally. So internally, the noise voltage is zero in ideal case. And zero output offset. The output offset is the output voltage of an op amp or amplifier when both the inputs are grounded. So when both the inputs are grounded means input is zero. In that case, output also zero in ideal case. But in real op amps, it has some amount of output offset voltage even though we are not applying any input. Next, infinite bandwidth. The ideal op amp will amplify all the signals from DC to the highest AC frequencies. So the bandwidth of the op amp is infinite in ideal case. In real op amps, the bandwidth is rather limited. Next, practical op amp. Here the figure represents the equivalent circuit of practical op amp. And in this case, we have some parameters in terms of physical components. We have some input impedance Rin. We have some output impedance R0, and we have some internal voltage source that is represented as AVLN into VD. This is the practical or equivalent circuit of an op amp. And next, the output voltage for the practical op amp is represented as V0. V0 is equal to AVL into VD. AVL into V1 minus V2. VD is the difference voltage, that is V1 minus V2. AVL is the lost signal open loop voltage gain. VD is the difference voltage, that is V1 minus V2. V1 is the non-inverting input voltage. V2 is the inverting input voltage. RA is the input resistance of the op amp. R0 is the output impedance of the op amp. Next, comparison between the ideal and practical op amps. So in ideal case, the input impedance of the op amp is infinite, but in practical, the input impedance is in between 500 kilo ohms to 2 mega ohms. In ideal case, the output impedance is zero, but in practical, the output impedance is in between 20 to 100 ohms. In ideal, the open loop gain is infinite, but in practical, the open loop gain is 20k to 200k. The bandwidth for the ideal op amp is infinite. The bandwidth for the practical op amp is limited, that is in few kilohertz. In ideal, we have some zero noise contribution, but in practical, we have some noise contribution. In ideal case, we have zero DC output offset voltage. In practical, we have non-zero DC output offset voltage. So next, configurations of an op amp. We have two types of configurations. One is open loop configuration and the one is closed loop configuration. So open loop configuration means we have no feedback from output to the input. This figure represents the open loop configuration of an op amp. Here we have no connection between output to the input. We have no feedback from output to the input. So this one is known as open loop configuration of an op amp. Here the output assumes one of two possible output states, that is plus Vsat or minus Vsat, and the amplifier acts as a switch lead. So we have output stages as plus Vsat or minus Vsat. We have some saturation voltages or maximum output voltage in open loop configuration. If the negative, that means the input to the inverting terminal is high, we have some negative saturation voltage. If the input to the positive terminal is high, we have some positive saturation voltage. That means it acts like a switch. So such an open loop behavior of an op amp finds some rare applications. That means it can be used as a voltage comparator, it can be used as some zero crossing detector, etc. So in this case, the output has no effect on the input. And next, the op amp works as high gain amplifier. That means it produces high gain because it can amplify the input signals as high as possible. And the op amp can be used in three modes in open loop configuration. They are differential amplifier, inverting amplifier, and non-inverting amplifier. We will discuss these three types of amplifiers in later sessions. And next, op amp is generally not used in open loop mode. So why? As open loop gain of the op amp is very large, very small input voltage drives the op amp voltage to the saturation level. Thus, in open loop configuration, the output is at its positive saturation voltage or negative saturation voltage, depending on which input V1 or V2 is more than the other. For AC input voltages, output may switch between positive and negative saturation voltages. That means here the output is not varied in accordance with the input. So that's why op amp is generally not used in open loop mode. So this indicates the open loop output, and this indicates the inability of the op amp to work as a linear small signal amplifier in the open loop mode. Hence, the op amp in open loop configuration is not used for the linear applications. So here we have some distorted output. So that's why. And the output is not linearly varies in accordance with the input. So these are the limitations what we have in open loop configuration. Next, closed loop configuration. The utility of the op amp can be increased considerably by operating in closed loop mode. Closed loop mode means here we have some feedback from output to the input by using some component. Here we are using some resistor in order to connect the input and the output. This one acts as a feedback resistor. This type of configuration is known as closed loop configuration. The closed loop operation is possible with the help of feedback. The feedback allows to feed some part of the output back to the input terminals. In the linear applications, the op amp is always used with negative feedback. That means in closed loop configuration, the output varies in accordance with the input, linear. So the op amp always used with negative feedback in order to get the linear operation. The negative feedback helps in controlling gain, which otherwise drives the op amp out of its linear range. So even for a small noise voltage at the input terminals. So in order to get the linearity at the output and in order to get some controlled gain, we are using the negative feedback. Thank you.